Hi, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. This is part two of how to create this Saturn-like planet in deep space. Picking up from where we left off, open the stone texture background I provided. Its link is in the video's description or project files. Click the new layer icon to make a new layer. Open your gradient tool. We'll use the same gradient that we used for the rings. Click the linear gradient icon. Go to the top of your document and press and hold Shift as you drag the linear gradient line to the bottom. Reduce the opacity to 50%. Click the adjustment layer icon and choose Hue Saturation. Check Colorize. I'll make the hue 30 and the saturation 10. However, feel free to use whatever you like. Make a composite snapshot of your image by pressing Ctrl-Shift-Alt-E on Windows or Command-Shift-Option-E on a Mac. Go to Filter, Distort, and Spherize. Make the amount 100% and click OK. To spherize it more, repeat the last filter by pressing Ctrl or Command F. Spherizing makes an image softer in the center, so let's sharpen it a bit more. There are many ways to do this, however, for this example, we'll use the Highpass filter. First, make a copy of the image by pressing Ctrl or Command J. Then, go to Filter, Other, and High Pass. Make the radius 3 pixels and click OK. Change the blend mode to overlay. As I toggle back and forth, you can see the difference. Essentially, High Pass only sharpens the edges of areas. Areas in the image which are not an edge are left untouched. Merge the two top layers by pressing Ctrl or Command E. Open your elliptical marquee tool. As before, drag a selection to the lower right corner. Go to Select and Transform Selection. Lock the width and the height, and in either field, type in 98%. To accept it, press Enter or Return twice. Cut and copy it to its own layer. To place your sphere into your planet background, press V to open your Move tool and drag the sphere on top of the Planet tab. Without releasing your mouse or pen, press and hold Shift as you drag it down onto your image. Next, we'll reduce its size and position. First, let's reduce its opacity so we can see the rings through it. Open your Transform tool, reduce its size, and reposition it so the sphere is centered over the opening in the rings. Then, press Enter or Return and bring its opacity back to 100%. I think I'd like to rotate the sphere a bit, so I'll open my Transform tool again and angle it. Next, we'll add a deep shadow on the right of the sphere. Click the new layer icon twice to make two new layers. Fill the top layer with black. To do this, you can press Alt or Option plus Delete if your foreground color is black. If it isn't black, press D on your keyboard first. Temporarily hide the top layer by clicking off the eyeball next to it. Ctrl-click or Command-click on the sphere to make a selection of its shape. Make the layer above the sphere active and fill the selection with black. Press Ctrl or Command-D to deselect it. Go to Filter, Blur, and Gaussian Blur. Blur it 25 pixels and click OK or press Enter or Return. Open your Transform tool and enlarge it approximately 144%. Position it over your sphere so a little more than half of it is in shadow. Then press Enter or Return. Control-click or Command-click on its thumbnail to make a selection of its shape. Now that we have its selection, we can trash the shape. Make the top layer visible and active. Press the Delete key on your keyboard to delete the black shape inside the selection, then deselect it. Control-click or Command-click on the sphere to make a selection of its shape. Invert the selection by pressing Ctrl or Command-Shift-I. With the top layer still active, press the Delete key. Your top layer should just be the shadow on the sphere. Then deselect it. Merge these two layers by pressing Ctrl or Command-E. To remove the fringe around the shadow of the sphere, go to Layer, Matting, and Defringe. Make the width 1 pixel and click OK. Next, we'll make the rings appear in front of the sphere. Control-click or Command-click on the rings to make a selection of its shape. Click the Layer Mask icon to make a layer mask of the selection next to the sphere. Invert the layer mask by pressing Ctrl or Command-I. Open your Pencil tool and make the hardness 100%. Make the foreground color white by pressing X on your keyboard. Carefully brush over the rings, which reveals the top of your sphere through the layer mask. Next, we'll cast a shadow onto the rings. Go to View, and if Snap is checked, click it to turn it off. Make your foreground color black. Click the New Layer icon to make a new layer. Control-click or Command-click on the sphere to make a selection of its shape. Fill the selection with black and deselect it. Temporarily reduce its opacity so we can see through it. Open your Transform tool and go to the top middle anchor point. When you see a vertical double arrow, press and hold Alt plus Shift on Windows or Option plus Shift on a Mac as you drag it in approximately this much. Go to a corner and drag it out. Rotate it to the same angle as your rings. Position it so the bottom middle anchor point is flush to the edge where the rings are the closest to us. Go to the top middle anchor point and drag it down to the point where the shadow is a little above the hole in the rings. Go to the right middle anchor point and drag it out approximately this much. Continue to finesse its position, angle, width, and size until the shadow looks good to you. Then press Enter or Return. Next, we'll make the stars show through the shadow that cover the empty areas of the rings. Control-click or Command-click on the thumbnail of the rings to make a selection of its shape. Click the Layer Mask icon to make a layer mask of the selection next to the top layer. As soon as you click the Layer Mask icon, your foreground and background colors automatically inverted. However, since we want to mask out the shadow on the left of the rings, our foreground color needs to be black. Press X on your keyboard. Brush over the shadow on the left up to the point where the shadow and the rings meet. Make sure you don't brush past this point, otherwise you'll brush out part of the shadow on the right. Bring back the shadow's opacity to 100%. To get rid of the fringe inside the shadow, make your ring layer active and Control-click or Command-click on it to make a selection of its shape. Click the Layer Mask icon to make a layer mask of the selection next to the rings. As I toggle back and forth, you can see the difference. It looks much better now because the layer mask clipped off the color fringe of the rings. The last step is to slightly blur the shadow on the rings the further away it gets from the sphere. Make the top layer active and open your blur tool. Make its size 125 pixels, its hardness 0%, and its strength 100%. Brush over the edge of the shadow once and again over the tip. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.